So 12th class, before vacations, we were doing MySQL. So I am revising few concepts again, right? Now, database in simple terms means the collection of data concerning any particular entity or any object. From different sources, we collect the data. Like, for example, a student is there. Regarding a student, what all information you can collect? You can collect name, admission number, class, section, roll number, father name, mother name, Aadhaar card, number, okay, then address, then phone number, email ID, city, right? So all this information you collect for a particular entity, and the information is represented in form of tables, right? Whatever information you collect in the database, the information is stored in form of table. And what is a table? Table is an arrangement of rows and columns, right? So in our syllabus, we have MySQL database, right? Now the term comes DBMS. What actually is DBMS? DBMS means Database Management System. It is basically a software that is used to manage the database effectively and efficiently. Right? And one term is there, RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. RDBMS means where data is arranged in form of relations. Relation means tables. In DBMS, relation is also known as table, right? So when you are working in MySQL database, first of all, our first work is to create one database. Unless and until we are creating the database, we cannot create the tables, right? So in order to create the database, our first command is create database, and you can give any name to the database. I am giving here the name commerce. All the students, please keep one notebook in front of you and keep noting down the commands which I am discussing with you all. Okay? Create database, commerce. Commerce is the name of database and semicolon. Query okay. One row affected means my database is successfully created. Now I have to connect with this database. So in order to connect with the database, I'll be using the command connect commerce. So now I am successfully connected with my database, and I can create as many tables inside this database as I want. As many table as you want, you can create inside this database commerce. Am I clear to everyone? Yes, class 12th, am I clear up till here, all of you? How to create database and how to connect with database? All right, so now we are to create one table. In order to create table, we'll be using command create table. Create table is a DDL command. What I mean by DDL, Data Definition Language. DDL covers all those commands which are related to physical structure of the table, which are related to physical structure of the table, like setting of the columns, setting of the data types of each column, right? Then rename table, then alter table, then drop table, all the commands which are in connection with the table. they are covered under DDL. Then there is one concept, DML, Data Manipulation Language. This covers all the commands which are in connection to the records of the table, like select, insert into, delete, update. Okay, so these commands are covered under the DML. Create table. Now give any name to the table. I am giving the name employee. Right? You can give any name you want. Don't put the semicolon. Press the enter key. Put the opening parenthesis. What you called round bracket. Okay? Now here, first of all, you have to specify the field name, what fields, what columns, or you can say attributes. There are three different names for one common thing: fields or columns or attributes. Okay, I am taking first of all E code space data type. Data type integer. You can write int also. I am writing integer. Integer will cover whole numbers, means number without fractions. Comma. Next, I am taking ename. Now, ename is of string type. Okay. Here you will enter the characters, the alphabets. You cannot enter number here because there is no such name which contain any number. So for this, I am taking the data type character. But if I take only character, it means one single character. So I have to specify the size of the data which can be accommodated in this field. I am taking 20 size. And when you specify size along with the character data type, it becomes string. Now this is not a single character. It has become a string and it can hold maximum of 20 characters. If I am clear up till here, please raise your thumb, all of you. Those who are attending the lecture seriously, all of you raise your thumb. I can see how many are present. Mohit Davar, Varun, 11 roll number, no response coming from your side. Nandini, no response. Vaibhav Roda, no response. Vanshika, can you please come on the video for 1 minute? So moving to the next field, I have E salary. I am taking it of float type. Okay. Float data type means it can accommodate fractional numbers. And the range and precision of float data type is much more than the range of integer data type. Right? Then next I have E department. Whether the employee belongs to purchase department, to sales department, to marketing department, to finance department. Okay. So again, it will be of type string. So I am specifying the size 20 here. You can specify any size as per your convenience. Now, next I am taking E city. Again, of type character I am taking. Okay. Now suppose this is my last field. I don't want any other field. This is my last field. So don't put comma after the end of the last field. Close the bracket which you have opened initially and put semicolon and your table get successfully created. Now, if you want to view the structure of your table, the physical layout of your table, the command is DESC, that is describe. DESC, it stands for describe. DESC and specify the table name. See, the physical structure of the table is now displayed in front of you. Fields are e-code, e-name, e-salary, e-department, e-city, their data types, null. Carefully see the null column. Null in Python, in MySQL means legal empty value. In Python, you might have studied that value none. That was legal empty value. In MySQL, the legal empty value is recognized by null. Null means empty, blank. It means in all the fields, you can skip any entry. You can leave the field blank. You can enter null value. Suppose I am not entering anybody's salary. मैं किसी एक एम्प्लॉय की सैलरी को स्किप कर रहा हूं, मैंने वो नल छोड़ दिया, मैंने वो ब्लैंक छोड़ दिया, राइट? दैट इज व्हाई यस 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 इज कमिंग. इन द कमिंग लेक्चर्स आई विल बी टेलिंग यू कॉन्सेप्ट अबाउट कंस्ट्रेंट्स दैट वेयर यू कांट एंटर द नल वैल्यू, यू आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड बाय द डाटाबेस टू एंटर द नल वैल्यू. ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट एंटरिंग द रिकॉर्ड्स इन द टेबल. नाउ we have created the structure. Now one by one we'll be entering the records, right? How to enter the record? Insert into. This is DML command, because now we are going to enter the records. So all the commands in connection to records of the table are contained inside the DML, right? Insert into employee values, opening round bracket, check the order of the fields in the table. In the same order, you have to enter the values of the field. If your field is of integer or float type, you can write as it is in the numeric form. But if your field is of type character, of type string, or date type, you have to enclose the value inside the single or double quotes. First value E code, it is of integer type. You can enter the value without any quotes, comma. E name, but obvious name is a type, name is a string type. So enclose the value in single quotes or double quotes. Okay. Then salary, again numeric type. Then coming to department, again string type. Sales department, enclose in single quotes. Then e-city, again string. Enclose in single quote. And put semicolon over here. One row get inserted, get created in your table. Aapke table mein ek record enter ho chuka hai. Am I clear up till here? Yes. 12th class, am I totally clear up till here? How to enter the record? Concept is clear to all of you? Shelza, Vidisha, Anshita, Jasdev, Varun Chauhan, is the concept clear to you? Varun Chauhan, Sukhmani, all right. Now to enter the next record, No need to type the command again. You can use the arrow keys. When you use the upper arrow key, the first command appears. Using left arrow key, you can make changes. You can make changes here. Okay. And okay, then third command, again make changes. Salary I'm giving 65 here. Department I am giving finance. Okay, city I am giving Mumbai. Right, then fourth command I am entering. Right, department I am giving marketing, and city I am giving Jabalpur. Then one more record I am going to enter. Right. Department sales. And city, Kolkata. Okay, so five records I have created for the table employee. Now you want to view the records. Whenever you want to put any query onto the table and you want to retrieve the desired records, the command is select. With the help of select command, you can put query onto the table. Select star. Whenever you will use asterisk, it means display the detail, complete detail. Okay. Here star means all the records of the table. Select star from keyword. In every MySQL command, you have to specify the from keyword. After the from keyword, you have to specify the table name. So whenever you will give this command, select star from table name, it will display all the records of the table. Semicolon. See here. Am I clear to all? Udit, Kia, Bhavneet. Jagraj, Jatin. Lagan, I am clear totally. Vaibhav, clear ho gaya sara? Vaibhav. Nandini, am I clear with the concept? Ruchika, Sanvinder, all right. Now suppose you don't want to display the complete detail, you want to display the selected fields. So after the select command, specify the field name which you want to print. Select E code, comma E name from employee. Select E code, comma E name from employee. Now you have specified two fields which you want to print, e code and e name. Okay. So here, whatever order you have given, in the same order, the field will get displayed. The order of the fields will decide the order of display. Right? You have given E code, then E name. So E code will be print first, E name will be print at the second time. Right? And see, only E code and E name are there. Clear? Similarly, you can specify other fields which you want. Like I want E code, E salary, E city from employee. Okay. Am I clear? E salary, E city. You can display three fields also, E code, E salary, comma, E department from employee. Clear? Any doubt? All right. Now suppose you want to display selected records that satisfy your criteria. For that, you have to put some condition. And in order to place the conditions in MySQL, you need a clause that is known as where clause. The role played by if function in Python is the same role played by where clause in MySQL database. Like for example, I want to display record of those employees whose E code is more than 1003. Select start, because I say detail. Whenever you see detail, you have to put asterisk. Select asterisk or the star from employee where E code more than 103, relational operator more than 1003, semicolon. So as per my criteria, only the record of employee code 1004 and 1005 has been displayed. Because these two records satisfy the condition. Clear, 12th class? Similarly, you can put other conditions. Select star from employee where E code equal to 103. Okay. So it will display the record of that employee whose E code is equal to 1003. Clear? Then I want to display the record of those employees whose E code is not equal to 1003. 1003 ke alawa jitne bhi employees hain sabka record print ho jaye. So for this, the symbol of not equal to is this. less than sign, greater than sign. See the table carefully. All the records are printed except 1003. So the symbol of not equal to in MySQL database is less than sign, greater than sign. Okay? Am I clear? Then I want to display E code, E name of those employees whose salary is more than 50,000. Select E code, comma, E name from employee where clause E salary more than 50,000. Right? Check the result. Clear 12th? So in this way you can frame lot many commands in MySQL database. Right? So you must be aware about the arithmetic operators and the relational operators in order to implement these commands. Then next command is between. Between operator is used in those cases where you want to display the records that satisfy certain range. When range of values is to be printed, like for example, I say display the detail of all those employees whose salary is in range 60,000 to 80,000. 60,000 to 80,000 ki range mein jitne bhi employees hain, their record should get displayed. But remember one important point here, that when you are using the between operator, both the value, the starting and the ending, they are included in the range. 60,000 to 80,000 means 60 is also included, 80,000 is also included. Select star from employee where e salary between 60,000 and 80,000. Carefully see the command. Between is used in those cases where you want to check for the range. Am I clear? Sixty and 80 both are inclusive. Clear? Then the next command is logical commands. Logical OR, and NOT. Logical OR you means the result is true if either of the expression is true. You have two expressions. If any one expression is true, the result is true. The result will be false only in that situation where both the expression are false. Right? Select star from employee where E salary equal to 70,000 or E salary equal to 95,000. Display the record of that employee whose salary is either 70,000 or 95,000. Now OR means either the first condition should get true, either the second condition should get true, or both the conditions get true. The result is true. See, both the records are displayed because both the conditions were true. If either of the condition gets true, then also in the OR case, the record will get print. The relevant record will get print. Am I clear? 12th class?